Yeah, I mean, in fact, if you remember back in the Ebola day, Tom Frieden, who was the CDC director at the time, and I were very public about wanting to have that kind of fund, and the fund was given, $100+ million, which the CDC is very well using right now.
Right, if I could just add, I absolutely agree that the creation of the funding last year by Congress of this emergency fund is a tool that the responders have that we didn't have 5 years ago, but that's not going to be enough. And I think that, again, particularly if we have more introduction of the disease in the United States, more state and local resources being pulled down, more resources in our healthcare system being pulled down, the administration is going to need an emergency supplemental. And by the way, that's a challenge on both ends of Pennsylvania Avenue. So on the one hand, I hope that someone at OMB is getting ready now to send this thing to the Hill and starting to really pulse the agencies for what they need. And I hope Congress is getting ready to act quickly. We were very fortunate in 2014. President Obama sent the emergency supplemental to the Hill. Congress passed it in 4 weeks. The next year, 2 years later in 2016, with the Zika response, it lingered up there for months before Congress acted on it. So yeah, I think let's just be fair here. I think there's a challenge for both ends of Pennsylvania Avenue. The administration needs to get this ready. Congress needs to be ready to act quickly when the administration sends it up.
So I think we're going to have to leave it there. Please join me in thanking these people for giving you so much time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Great job.